It's September 25th, 2018. I'm headed north to meet my dad and his good buddy Lee. Headed up to northern British Columbia for archery moose hunting there. So something that we've had planned for like 2.5 years now. It's crazy, it's already here. It doesn't seem real, but yeah, headed up, gonna meet him today, and we've got like a 32-hour drive or something crazy up there before we hop on a float plane. I think it's gonna be about an hour plane ride into the lake, and from there on out, it's a 10-day straight archery moose hunt. We're all gonna have fishing license, so do some fishing and maybe run into some moose and possibly a wolf. But yeah, I'm excited. It's gonna be an awesome trip. Gone for the next like 2 to 2.5 weeks, so gonna be completely off grid, no service, no nothing. So it's gonna be an awesome couple weeks. Finally got here last night around 11:30 midnight. It was a long trip, 3 wrong turns, so we ended up driving about 3 or 4 hours extra. But I blame it on the scenery because we were just in awe at how awesome the mountains were and waterfalls and glaciers and everything. So we just kept driving before we realized. But anyways, yeah, it was like 28 to 30 hours somewhere in there, 2 days. So it's good to finally get here, packing up some stuff, making sure we got everything, and then we're gonna meet float plane on the dock here in like 3 or 4 hours, and if the weather holds, hopefully fly out, and we're gonna fly right into the lake right at camp. So yeah, pretty excited. But here's the little room we got last night. Sure beats the side of the road the night before for a couple hours crash.
Rain. lady spitting at the Nicky Jacks. Businessman with a needle and a spoon. Coyote chewing on a cigarette. Pack of young boys going howling at the moon. Hey, darling, sleeping on the blacktop. Hey, darling, running through the trees, honey. Hey, darling, leaving for the next town. Lesson my sense catches up with me. Crash on a number four. Two witnesses blowing up high. Not sure whose will be done. You can call me a sinner for wondering why. Hey, darling, sleeping on the blacktop. Hey, darling, running through the trees, honey. Hey, darling, leaving for the next town. Lesson my sense catches up with me.
Swinging He's around, good. Pete.
Yep.
Get me pointed. I gotta have a. Hello.
Hi.
I'm Brian.
Hi.
Hi
there.
How are you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Flying.
That's a good pilot.
Hey, darling, sleeping on the blacktop. Hey, darling, running through the trees, honey. Hey, darling, leaving for the next town. Lesson my sense catches up with me. Hey, darling, sleeping on the blacktop. Hey, darling, running through the trees, honey. Hey, darling, leaving for the next town. Lesson my sense catches up with me.
Here's a little tour of our cabin. My bunk here, my dad's, and then Lee's crashing there. Not a bad little setup.
After unpacking our gear and settling in, my dad and Lee both shot their bows to make sure they were still on, and we spent the rest of the day hanging around camp, getting to know Pete, Carl, and Kelly, as well as talking to them about what this next week and a half would look like for us.
Came her in like
update. It's day five of the 10-day hunt. Weather's been too good, like really cold but clear, no clouds. So between that and the moon being pretty much full moon, rut activity has been pretty slow. So actually last night was the first night that my dad and I saw any moose. We saw a little bull and a cow across the lake from camp. So first time we saw moose, but anyways, day one, super slow. Day two, we heard a bull grunting, which was cool because neither of us have ever heard that. So That was pretty cool. That was the second morning. That was it for the day. He must have had a cow, we figured, because he didn't come in. Day three, we hiked up to a cool lookout. It was about a 2.5 mile hike, pretty good hike up there. And spent the day up there and checked everything out. It was an awesome spot. You could see everything. A little steep. Awesome view though.
At least we're not doing this the first day.
Yeah, they warmed us up a little bit. They had a plan all along. It's like, we better not kill
them. Or the last day.
And tomorrow you'll sleep in.
No, we're going to go kill one in that drainage. Okay. That's what we're going to do. Yeah.
We'll calm their ass down.
Oh. Lean forward into the hill.
You don't want me to knock him down.
The rope, everybody.
We all have our definitions of fun.
You ever killed a moose back here?
Oh, lots.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. But they're fun to back out.
Right here?
Yeah.
Pick them up on this lake.
Oh, they'll fly in?
Yeah.
Okay. There you go. Yep.
But we got up there and heard a wolf howl. And then about 10-15 minutes later, I glassed up four wolves kind of running through the trees. Two black ones and two gray. So that was pretty cool to see those guys, but they were headed out of the area we were hunting, which is good. So we didn't try and call them back in. So if they would have been coming closer or stuck around there, we would have tried to call them in. They were about a mile away or so.
Day four yesterday was, again, pretty slow. We hiked over to a different lake. Lots of sign, but nothing. And then when we got back is when we saw that cow and little bull. So today is day five. This morning was freezing. The lake was starting to freeze over, so hopefully some clouds roll in and gets a little bit warmer, because if it stays that cold, I figured two or three more days and this lake would be completely frozen and we couldn't fly out. So they're going to give them a call today, back to civilization, and see what the weather's doing. And if it's staying this cold, we might have to cut the hunt short, because we won't be able to fly out. Nobody would be able to come get us. So that would be a bummer. Hopefully the weather cooperates and warms up a little bit. But yeah, I mean, beautiful country. It's an amazing place. Completely off the grid. I think we're over 100 miles from where we flew into. There's some other hunting camps around, but you know, we're over 100 miles from any road or any airport. So awesome place, great people. Yeah, those guys are good people for sure. So it's been great so far, and hopefully we start running into some moose. It's day nine. We're actually waiting right now for a plane to come in. The weather's getting pretty crappy, so we have to get out of here before we're stuck. But it's been one hell of an adventure, and it's not over yet. So, quick update. Fifth day, the fifth night, we saw a little bull across the lake and got on him pretty quick, but he didn't come back into the call. Sixth day, we actually called in a bull for the first time, so that was an awesome experience. We called him in from like a mile away. He came in running and grunting, and first time we had ever experienced anything like that with a moose.
Whoa.
That was cool. I think you made it.
That was cool.
Yeah, no one gave us. It's right there.
Yeah.
15. 15 is what I was guessing.
I was like top 10.
He had a good clean shot too. It wouldn't have been too high. If his paddles would have been a little taller,
I know.
I would have smoked him.
I know. That was really cool, but we actually passed on him. He was about 15 yards. My dad was at full draw and could have got a good shot, and I got it all on video. It was awesome. He just was a pretty young bull. So that was the 6th day, 7th day. We didn't have anything. We had a snowstorm come in, and we did have a lynx walk by us. So that was pretty cool to see. First lynx I've ever seen.
Fresh out the boat in the promised land, 24 hours, got a gun in my hand. Sagebrush prayer by Zagan Sea, God bless, manifest destiny. Night of hot drinking and I met a bad man, traded money for my soul and my quick hand. Contract paying for some men to be dead, paid me silver to fix it with lead. Thoughts are circling overhead, there's a number to my death song. Covered in blood and I only see red, living too fast, won't last long. Ever on the run, never look back, son. Live by the gun and you're gonna die young.
The next day, which was yesterday, we went back to a lake just below the lookout and sat there. I spotted a big bull across the lake.
A flash of gunpowder and a streak of light, my spirit will vanish into the night. In sin and hate, I die right here. Ghost go west to disappear. Thoughts are circling overhead, there's a number to my death song. Covered in blood and I only see red. Living too fast, it won't last long. Ever on the run, never look back, son. Live by the gun and you're gonna die young. Ever on the run, never look back, son. You live by the gun and you're gonna die young.
His paddles were covered in snow, and so when he stood out, his paddles were completely white. He turned his head and we took off after him, and Carl called him in from probably about half a mile away.
Thank you.
Whoa.
Here, grab another.
Dad made a shot and it was back, and I grabbed another arrow, tried to get the camera back on him, and he put another arrow in him, and right away we could tell, I mean, he was hurting, and he was bedded down for about an hour, and a little bull came in, started grunting, and it caused that bull to get up, and so he got up and walked into the timber, and we could just tell it was a lethal hit, part of lung and liver probably, but anyways, we had decided to completely back out, leave him overnight. We were going to come back this morning. Well, when we got back to the boat to get picked up, Pete had told us that the weather was bad, so the plane was scheduled to be here this morning. We had to fly out or else we were going to be stuck. Well, turns out that wasn't the case. The weather was all right, and the plane's not even here yet. So anyways, we went back in right away, and sure enough, he was bedded right there, and he jumped up, and he was hurting. He was close to being dead, and he ran into the lake, and these guys have told us ever since we got in here, usually if they run to the lake, it's a good thing. Let them be there. They'll float, go get them in the boat, bring them to shore, cut them up. He ran into the lake and died and sank. So we are trying to figure out what the next step is. These guys have never seen this in, you know, 30 plus years of guiding and never heard of it or anything. So we're waiting on the plane, and then we're gonna be shuttled over to the next lake. It's about a mile from here, and see if we can see him, and if not, we'll do everything we can to try and get him from the bottom. And it's been a roller coaster. It was an amazing experience. That bull is an awesome animal, beautiful. So crossing our fingers and saying a lot of prayers that we can hopefully go recover him here soon. It's part of it. Something sucks, but it's been an incredible experience. Fingers crossed we can go find him and recover him, and definitely gonna remember this for forever. That's the update, and hopefully we can get the moose and a bunch of pictures and video of that. Alright.
It is June 21st, and the last part of this video you probably saw was back in October. Long story short, we did everything that we could before we absolutely had to get out of there due to the weather, but we were not able to recover that bull, unfortunately. So it's been an extremely long winter. I know we've all been thinking about it, but we've decided that we're gonna go back up and give it a shot and see if we can't fly back in there and get that bull recovered. So I'm actually packing right now. My dad's gonna be driving up tomorrow, and then we're gonna hit the road, go meet back up with Pete and Carl, and then go fly back in there. So it's gonna be an awesome adventure. I'm really looking forward to getting back up there. Hopefully we can go up there and get him found. It's been iced over the entire winter, and we don't know if that bull resurfaced, obviously, got drug off by a grizzly. We have no idea. So, currently packing, and we've got all sorts of different ropes, pulleys, come-alongs, wetsuits, you name it. Once we get up in there, we can't necessarily just run to the store if we need to pick up anything. So, we're going to try and take everything that we might possibly need and fly back in there for a few days and hope for the best. So, stay tuned. Hopefully we can go put our hands on this bull finally.
30 plus hour drive north was filled with anticipation and nervousness. I think we both accepted the fact when we left the previous year that we probably wouldn't step foot in that country again. So just the thought of going back to that same area was really exciting. The plan was to fly back into that lake, and before landing, we were going to circle several times to see if we could spot any sign of that bull from the air first. If unsuccessful, we were going to get dropped off at the lake. The pilot was then going to turn around and pick up Pete, Kelly, and the rest of the gear, and we were going to set up camp for 2 to 3 days while searching for the bull. At this point, we had made it around that lake 2 full times, flying as low and slow as possible, searching for any sign of that bull, with no luck. I thought for sure we were going to have to land and set up camp, search for the bull the hard way, and about that time, I heard the pilot say through the headset that he might see something.
Laying out in the water.
Oh,
That was a long 9 months.
That was a long hour flight in.
How did you guys spot
right there.
That?
Right there.
Well.
Beyond speech.
I don't know what to say when it happened, and I don't know what to say now.
Well, you say hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
You got above and beyond what most people would ever consider.
Oh.
Yeah. But.
And well worth it for
me. Oh, more than well worth it.
Yeah.
What I was hoping for.
Oh, when we condition. Were flying it, I couldn't
I
see.
Could, well, I couldn't see nothing from out here. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
What an ending to this. What an ending.
Oh, brilliant. Well, it's nice knowing that's a little swimming.
There he is. Look at that, guys. There he is. Oh, give me a hug. Oh. There he is. Almost 10 months.
You know, and I mean, I don't care what he scores. I am just blessed.
He might even be a little better than that. He'll be, that's a huge Canadian. See, he's so tall on his back.
He's 5 miles.
Yeah, he's 45 inches up the back. He might be 225 up.
Look at that, guys. Just,
here, let's spin him around.
Look at that.
Oh, my God.
Look at that, guys.
He's this, clean.
Oh.
Quick.
He's probably.
Oh man.
Oh. Bottom actually is strange because he's walking right here. Where he kills it is the length.
I knew he was nice, but I never.
Sitting lower on this.
Yep, here.
Right, let me take one here though, because it's definitely back. Worth. Yep. Hold on one sec. We'll take one here.
Here I go again, straight up out the motel. Hop my guitar out of a pine-side jail. If I quit, I miss a roll and the dice. Couldn't pass up the red beans and rice. Singing, oh my, my. See them girls shake their ass underneath the sunrise. Oh my, my. Taste the sugar on the lips underneath that moonlight.
Thank you. And again, what a beautiful day for flying, huh?
Oh yeah, good on you guys for making the effort.
Yeah. The minute we got back to self-service, I left Tina Massey. You guys were hunting for, what, 3-4 days?
Yeah.
And then he called me right back, and he goes, I'm so glad I came back to your message because we were thinking the same thing you guys were. We just we're like, we're going back. We have to.
he's putting two and two together right now. What a day.
Oh, what an ending.
Exciting.
Look at that. What do you think?
I'm seriously disappointed.
That you didn't get to come in? Sure, probably 100 yards.
Probably about, it was right around that point.
He was tipped up. And, yeah. Wow.
That was a good feed.
We were ready.
Wow, that's a beauty. That's nice. That's real loose.
That skull's fine.
Did you guys see him the first guy time by?
I didn't.
I was looking, I didn't see him at all.
I was looking for like pure white, something that stands out. And like once he pointed him out, I was like, oh, there he is. But it
yeah.
He is.
Yeah. One. It's one little broken or something right there, or it didn't grow.
That's good.
Oh, here, this is broken over there.
That was kind of
break too.
Nope, maybe not.
This is what moose hunters look for. I mean, it doesn't matter. Yeah, a big bull's a big bull, but this is when they do that. That's son of a gun. And not a lot of ground.
Now you're really glad that you decided to have
that part does not matter to me.
No, of course not.
We decided to set up a camp that night before starting the long drive home the next morning. We spent our time reminiscing about this hunt, talking about all of the crazy details and everything that happened, as well as reminiscing on other past hunts. It was a perfect way to wrap everything up before starting our long drive home.
I'll be the one that's snorkeling in between the rocks.
And when we came in the last time, I think we landed, and I was looking, it blended in so well. It blended in really well.